The Olympus TG-6 is a camera that continues a very rugged and durable lineage. It's compact, shoots 4K, has electronic image stabilization, and this is a point-and-shoot camera, wait for it, with changeable lenses. I mean, how does that even work? But is the toughest camera on the internet actually any good? Let's find out. What's up everyone, I'm the Everyday Dad, and if I can figure it out, you can figure it out. So I really like tough cameras. I mean, I've been a gigantic fan of action cameras for years, as some of my favorite pastimes are both mountain biking and mountain climbing. And in fact, one of the reasons that I even started covering cameras on this channel at all is because durable cameras that can go anywhere are quite literally something that just absolutely fascinates me. And when Olympus recently released this update, I mean, I had to give it a shot. First off, before we get too far into the video, I would like to thank my friends over at B&H Photo for loaning me this Olympus TG-6 for the next couple of weeks to make this series of videos on. Now, if you'd like to get your own camera that's so tough it can actually eat other cameras, there will be links in the description below. And as this has a pretty darn dual-headed rule, I do want to specify and mention right off the bat that I'm a video person, so I will not be talking about the photography capabilities of this camera. It does have some pretty impressive stills chops, but that's not what I talk about here. Now, if you've never heard of the TG-6 or know what it's capable of, let's cover some of the very basic video recording specs to get us all on the same page. Now, the TG-6 is a rugged point-and-shoot camera from Olympus. It has a 12-megapixel, 1/2-inch backside illuminated sensor. Built into the body itself, which is really the biggest selling point for a camera like this, is the 25-100mm equivalent lens that's f2 at the wide and f4.9 at the zoom. It can record up to 4K 30 frames per second and 1080p at up to 120 frames per second for slow motion. And if you want even slower slow motion, it can do 720p at up to 240 frames per second, and even lower quality than that at 480. That's pretty nuts. It's also got built-in electronic image stabilization, which, if that's anything like GoPro or DJI is currently doing, that should be a fantastic addition. Now, something that I don't normally cover in the specs overview, but I figured this would be a great time to mention it, is actually the durability features. Now, this camera, it's durable. It's waterproof rated at IPX8 for underwater depths up to 50 feet, freeze proof to temperatures as low as 14 degrees Fahrenheit, it's shock proof for falls from 7 feet, it's crush proof to withstand up to 220 pounds of pressure, and it's dust proof rated to IP6 to protect the internal components of the camera. Now that is insane for a camera. Even GoPros don't have the durability rating that this has, and GoPros are like the gold standards of durability. It's crazy. So let's break this down into different subsections that I think are the most important for a video camera, and more specifically, the subsections that are most important for the online content creator. First up, video quality. Now, like I mentioned during the spec overview, this camera can record up to 4K 30 frames per second. And that, for me, that's my preferred resolution and frame rate. I'm not a 24 frames per second shooter, I like 30. Now, speaking of 24 frames per second, where this does run into problems is much like the newer Canon cameras, this can't do any 24 frames per second modes, neither in 1080p or 4K. Now you could get close by switching it into PAL mode and recording in 25 frames per second, but if you want true 24 or 23.976, you'll have to look elsewhere. You're just not gonna find it here. But when it comes to the actual image quality, I think it looks pretty good. I mean, it's not fantastic, but it does what I'd expect from a camera with a sensor this size. And one of the nice benefits is the lens. I mean, f2 at the wide gives you better low light capabilities than a camera of this size really has any right to have. Now, on the other hand, this is made by a camera manufacturer, so it doesn't have all of the computational stuff built into cameras like modern cell phones. So while it's got a great sensor inside of it, and the zoom lens is great, if you were planning to only use this at like the widest 25mm setting, I think you'd be better off by getting a rugged case for your cell phone. The lens though looks great. I like its ability to actually have a rugged camera that can also save you from needing to move like too far off of the trail if you do have a particular shot in mind. Now, something else that's nice when it comes to the video quality is this can also do some crazy macro video work, which is something that cell phones and even action cameras just, they very much struggle with. I mean, they can only focus so close, and when I'm out on the trail, sometimes I find something really interesting. I find little interesting bugs or little interesting plants or flowers or something, and I'd really like to get close-ups of those. And that's a really useful feature in the TG-6. This even has a microscope mode that gets like crazy close. However, image quality is only half the battle, and surprisingly the audio here is both a pretty big positive and a little bit of a negative. Now, to clarify, when I say it's a bit of a negative, that's because this camera doesn't have any kind of microphone in jack, and I say it's a little bit because, I mean, this is fully waterproof. I don't know that you'd actually be able to fit anything like that in here without compromising the build quality, though GoPro has figured out a way to make it work with their huge adapter, but you do lose waterproofness then. When I say it's a big positive though, as you'll hear here in a second, the internal microphones are actually really good for a waterproof camera. Now, normally when you record with something like a GoPro, the audio is fine, but there's like a dampening that happens to the actual sound. But here, you actually have control over the internal preamps and can turn up or down the gain on the camera, which is a feature all cameras need, and it's something that like durable cameras rarely ever had. So voices picked up from the camera are actually pretty darn good, like surprisingly good. And I have to give Olympus credit here, because engineering that particular feat, that's gotta be difficult, right? Like, that's not just something easy where you can make like audio sound good from a waterproof body. Like, that's crazy. But let's put all of that to the test and hop outside for a quick video / vlogging test. And welcome to the vlogging test of the Olympus TG-6, which is probably the toughest camera I've ever tried out. Now, we're shooting in 4K 30 frames per second. We've got the electronic image stabilization turned on, and we have the sound recording because I thought it was a little too hot during our unboxing video on Monday. I have it turned all the way down. Now, that's pretty impressive for a camera of this price point and this feature set. Now, what this camera really is for, it's not necessarily meant to be a vlogging camera. It's more for like somebody, you're out and about, you're on the trails, you're in the mountains, you need some macro photography of like a cool bug or a cool rock, or you wanna take this underwater because, again, this is waterproof and shockproof. This is basically a camera that you would wanna take if you don't want your phone to get like destroyed. My really big problems with this is if you wanna use this as like a vlogging camera, which you could, because again, image quality, it's not great. We are again shooting in 4K 30. We're shooting it at super high bit rate, which they don't say, but I would hope it's around like 100 megabits or 200 megabits. But what the real problems are is the stabilization is not very good. In these days of action cameras having like the most cutting edge stabilization, like a camera like this, it really has its optical zoom. And that's the only reason that you would get this over an action camera or just buy a rugged case for your phone. And does it do okay for that? I prefer the image quality out of my phone, but this is, you know, this is what you could get if you were to get the Olympus TG-6. It's not terrible by any stretch of the imagination. It's not bad. It's just like 450 bucks is kind of a steep price for what you get out of this. But this has been the vlogging test. Back to the video. Back indoors. Yeah, I mean, my only complaint so far about this camera is the stabilization. I mean, it's just not that great for video work. I do wish they had something like the GoPro Hyper Smooth. I mean, the image quality besides that is good enough for the price you pay and the kind of camera that it is. But getting that image quality easy and reliably is actually more important to me than the image quality itself. So how well does this camera work for ease of use? This is probably the worst category overall for the TG-6. I mean, physically, it's got pretty much everything you could want out of a camera. The body feels amazing. It's got a mode dial button on the back, and on top you get a dial for changing certain settings. Now, I do wish you could do a lot more here, because where the camera fails is there is no manual mode, and that's pretty disappointing to me. I mean, you can do aperture priority, you can set it to auto, intelligent auto, macro, video, and underwater, but there's no way to have control over the aperture, the shutter speed, and the ISO all at the same time. Plus, the menus are not something I've enjoyed using. Now, in all fairness, I haven't used very many Olympus cameras in the past, so I'm sure I could get used to it in time, but I've been using this for about 3 days now, and it just has not gotten any better. I really do not like the menu systems here. Now, something that you can do, when you press the OK button, you get access to the quick menu, which is less of a quick menu, and it's more of like how you actually change the settings. Now, normally the quick menu just has things that you want quickly, not like the way that you can change the resolution. So you do everything from resolution to white balance, etc., from the quick menu, and I don't like that. Now, another big negative for me is the rear screen, while big and bright and it's easy to see, it's not a touch screen. Now, maybe this is a holdover for me, but being used to today's action cameras, I really like having a touchscreen and just swiping through to change the settings that I want. And I think a lot of my problems with usability here could be fixed by having a touchscreen. Now, it's not all gloom and doom. Something nice about the interface is it does actually have an audio meter to check levels while you're recording, but positives and negatives, there's no flip screen, so you can't actually see this if you are in front of the camera. So, bleh. Now, the buttons are all very nice and responsive, and I do like the physical layout of the camera. I just wish the user interface was a little better. I mean, it's not the worst, but it's not good. Now, after hitting record, does the usability change? Well, again, it's a stumbling block for me. Now, there are three main things that I look for after I hit record on a camera: stabilization, monitor, and autofocus. Well, with a sensor this small, you don't really need to worry about autofocus, as the depth of field is huge. I mean, you will need to worry about focus, but not very much, and it does okay for focusing. Now, the big problem, like we already mentioned though, the stabilization isn't great. There are lots of jitters found while hand holding the TG-6, and obviously there is no flip screen or even a tally light to know if you're recording. So that's just for, I like at least knowing if the camera's on, so I'm not wasting clips. So let's say you decide to buy one of these cameras though, what does the ecosystem look like? And honestly, this is the part of the video that I have most been excited to talk about, because normally when I'm covering a point and shoot camera, there is no ecosystem. What you see is what you get. But here, you can actually buy some game changing accessories. Like this front mount, it comes off, and does so without compromising the waterproofness of the camera. So when I said that during the unboxing, I was wrong. Sometimes you just gotta admit when you were wrong. You gotta be the bigger person. I was wrong. What this lets you do is install macro lights, fisheye lenses, better lens caps. I mean, there's all sorts of things that not only change how the camera works, but it lets you do this while you are, like, say, underwater, or in a situation where you don't want to unmount the camera and remount it after you've done whatever switching or changing that you've done. I mean, that's huge. And it's such a unique feature that I've never seen on a point and shoot camera that this might sell the camera by itself. And like we mentioned during the vlogging test, image quality is not necessarily the most important, but being able to change up what you want on the fly, now that's amazing. That legitimately, that's amazing. But at the end of the day, so what, right? So should you get an Olympus TG-6? So if you are looking for a single camera for your YouTube channel, no, you should not get the TG-6. This is a super niche camera, which while good at what it does, it isn't something that you should get as your only camera. But if you are looking for a good enough image, super rugged camera to take into the mountains or underwater, then yeah, I would start recommending this to you. It's probably one of the toughest cameras that I've ever come across, and the changeable lens mount on a point and shoot, that still blows my mind. Thanks for watching.